Hi everybody, I'm Diana. Welcome to my channel, Sew in Common, where we create patchwork quilting with the hoop of our embroidery machine. All of those lovely blocks, all created with your embroidery machine. And we love doing that here at Sew in Common. It's the next generation of patchwork quilting. And today we're going to talk about something that these three blocks all have in common, the color white. What is the color white? Do we really care as quilters? Well, stay with me because that's what we're going to talk about today and we'll figure it out together. Okay, everybody, welcome again to our channel. We're so glad to have you all with us. So these three blocks, they all have the color white in them. What is white though, really? Do those color whites all look the same to you, or do you see differences? Well, why don't we talk about what the color white is first? So I'm going to hold up a card, this right here. This is called White Dove. It is the white of 2024. It is what I call candlelight. So you've heard me talk about that color before, candlelight. Well, they're calling it White Dove this year. That's fine. That's great. But why don't we talk about what white is? And before we get started, let me just say, I know some of you were tuning in today thinking that this was going to be the layout week for our quilt along, which that block is a part of. Stay tuned until the end of this video. We're going to talk more about the quilt along. We've had to make a couple of little changes due to a real scheduling snafu on my part. So just stick with us. We'll talk about that towards the end of the video. So let's get back to what is white, which white is right for me as a quilter. Let's just take a look. So in science, they will tell us that white has no hue. Okay. It is just brightness. But it comes about from the mixing in a prism of all colors. So all colors on a meter will give you a certain wavelength. And when those colors are all in their purest form and mixed together through a prism, we get pure white, or what I like to call pure light, because it really is brightness. White is the color, technically, that reflects out all other colors. So if you see something and you go, oh, that's kind of a blue white, well, what you're actually seeing there is white where the blue is not, whatever blue they used was not at its perfect wavelength or perfect color. It was slightly different. That's giving it that blue hue or cast to it. So that's kind of how white works in a scientific way. But as quilters, we just want to know, how do we use white? How do we pick white? Is there a perfect white? So I hope that we can answer some of these questions today. And if you wanted to know, I did a little looking to find out, like, what does the color white indicate throughout the world? Well, it's always kind of indicated the idea of purity, sacrifice. But in ancient Rome, the color white indicated your citizenship as a citizen of Rome. So that's interesting. I don't think many, I don't know of any countries, I could be wrong, but I know here in the United States, wearing a certain color doesn't indicate to the rest of the population that you are a citizen. Now, of course, we like to wear the colors in our flag sometimes, especially like on patriotic holidays and stuff like that. But that doesn't indicate your citizenship. Anybody can wear those colors, right? But in ancient Rome, if you wore white, it indicated that you were a citizen of Rome. I thought that was kind of an interesting trivia piece for us. Okay, so I'm going to show you some white fabric, and we're going to talk about, is it actually white or is it not white? Because remember, a white is that perfect reflection of light, all colors, and there's only one of those, right? So let's start out by showing you this one. Beautiful, right? lovely white. This is not the candlelight. This is not candlelight. This is more what I would call a cream color, a really light cream. In fact, pretty sure this is the white we have up in that block. The whites in these three blocks are not the same white, to answer that question. And so this is more of a cream. This has more red or yellow combinations that come through so that it's not the perfect white. But is it the perfect white for your quilt? Well, for that block, it was the perfect white. And we're going to talk about how we can pick the perfect white. But let's look some more. This white, is that a perfect white? It kind of looks like it's a pretty good reflection of white as I'm looking. And I will tell you right now, it is dove white, or what I call candlelight. This, for me, is the perfect white. I love using it in my quilts, and I actually buy it by the bolt so that I always have plenty of it. But we'll talk about here in a minute. I'll give you a tip on how to use white if you find you don't have enough of one particular fabric and you can't get out to the store to get some more. So this is that dove white. Beautiful, but not pure white. Again, but for me, it's my perfect white. And then this one right here, again, it certainly looks white, but really it's what we would call a coffee cream color, or that's the color it's called, coffee cream, because it is not, it's not dove white and it's not pure white. Do you want to see pure white? This, that's pure white. Look at the brightness of that up on my face. It just brightens my face right away, right? Let's look at this coffee white. Not nearly as much. Ooh, bright. Ooh, not so bright. Because this is pure white. It's reflecting out all the colors. So for pure white, I'm sorry, I've got strings all over me this morning from digging in my white. So let me show you something right now. I've got some other pieces over here I'm going to show you, and when we talk more about picking whites. This bucket, you guys have seen me talk about these buckets from IKEA. This is my bucket of whites. And you can tell right here on top, these first two colors are not the same. White and, or let's see, coffee white and pure white. So I mix them all in here when I'm working with them. And then I dig through them to find out what I need as I'm going to make my quilts. But like I said, the coffee, dove white, or what they're calling dove white, I keep that by the bolt because I love using it. It, for me, again, is my perfect white. But this pure white, whoops, this pure white is just that reflection of everything. Now, you can find a lot of these like little blender pieces that are prints, technically, that read as a solid. You can find those. These are the Lori Holt B cross stitch that I've told you all about, that I've shown you, that we used in several of our other blocks. This is it, but where the cross stitch is the color and the background is the white, but it's not a pure white. This is more that dove white that we're seeing from this year. So it's a really popular white for sure. Let's look at another one. This is our, do you guys remember making this year? This was our table runner from our Dirty Snowballs. You can still get this pattern and all over at our website. It's a free pattern, and the quilting pattern is out there too. And so the background for this, I use pure white. And let's talk about why I used pure white now. On this one, let's look at the colors. Even though I've got some beiges and browns in here, everything in here, let me verify that I'm not telling you a story, as my grandmother would say, meaning a fib. Yes, everything in here has white in it. And all of these colors, all of these fabrics are pretty bright in and of themselves. And so when I went to choose a white, if I had chose the candlelit color. It might have dulled some of these colors out a little bit, and I wanted this to be really bright. So that is a pure white on the background. And the reason it got chosen was because of the other colors being bright in and of themselves. So that's tip number one. When choosing white fabric, look at the colors you're using. Are you using more muted tones, pastels, really bright colors, really deep saturated colors? That can help guide you to what white is good for that particular project. Because even though I love this dove white, it's my favorite, or what I call candlelight, it might not be the perfect white for every single project. So let's look back at this one now, this particular block. This block has a lot of color in it, a lot of pattern in it. My half square triangles and then my center square all have color. And my four solid blocks on the corners are even still patterns, but they would be, I would consider them a white fabric. However, notice they have little bits of gray all through them. So when I was looking for a white to go with these, because let's look at these have really dark, they're bright, but they're dark colors. This one actually with the black butterflies over the white polka dots gives a gray cast to it. That's that mixing idea of color. And in here, these are really super bright, but with the black added, it really gives off and lends itself to more of a gray tone. Well, I didn't want to do gray in here because I still wanted to keep everything bright, but choosing a white that had these little gray diamonds in them was perfect. It gave that little bit of a gray tone, but still the brightness of the white in the background of it. So that's another tip. When using fabrics with black, always try and find a white that helps brighten, but also doesn't cast too much of a shadow on your colors. So gray. So if I would have used black and white, this would have been a much darker, darker square. But with the gray and white, it doesn't cast too much of a shadow over everything. So that's what I did for this one. Now let's take a look. This is not actually one that I made on the embroidery machine. I made this one years ago. It's a little wall hanging that you can see, and there's white in every single square. But look at that. It has a lot of taupe. It has a lot of gray. It has a lot of green, a lot of muted yellows. All of those colors are more muted. And the whites that are in them, in fact, let's look at the back of it because you can see the solid squares in this one. The white in them is a more muted white because the colors are more muted in the color fabric. If I were to use a super bright white with this, this white would overtake these softer colors. So in this case, that beautiful candlelit color blends in really beautifully. If I wanted more white, I could do that. But there's another choice you could use here too. You could use this coffee cream white in here too. That's even softer and blends beautifully in with these muted colors. So when looking at muted colors, look at a more muted white or something that has hue, meaning that when we're talking scientifically again, the mix of the color wasn't, everything wasn't perfect. There's something in it had a little bit more color to it, and that color is radiating through. And that's how we get these more muted whites. They're all considered white in the white family of fabric, but not all white is going to work with all pieces. And so to answer the question, is there a perfect white? I'm going to say no. I'm going to say a big no on that one, because as we can see, depending on the colors you're working with, you might want a softer white, or you might, if you're making a summer quilt, so you can even see in this block here, this is part of our quilt along. These are the fabrics I'm using for that. I chose a white on white. So if you look really closely, this is not a solid, it's a print. It's a white on white. The background white is softer, but the print on it is super vibrant white. And that's just enough of the vibrant white to pick up the whites in my other two colors. So if you're making a summer quilt, the vibrant white is probably going to be your best friend because you're probably going to choose brighter colors. Even pastels can be super bright in the hue of the pastel. That way, a pure white might work beautifully. If you're going to do something more in the fall and you're going to be using softer tones, then something like this coffee cream might work beautifully for that. Or you might even want to head more into a beige or a taupey color, which is white heading into the brown family. Okay, so if you're going to do something at the holidays, if you're going to do something for a red-green themed holiday quilt, then depending on the red and green, that will help indicate what white you might want to throw in with it. If you're using a very traditional red and green color scheme for the holiday, then closer to a pure white will probably work for you. If you're using those more muted retro greens and reds, then again, you're going to want to go with a dove white or coffee cream white, anything like that, that gives more of that retro look to it. And then if you are doing something in a blue and silver now, or white, blues and silvers around some of the other end of your holidays can be beautiful in pure white, but they can also look really great if you choose a white that has a little bit of a gray touch to it as well, because that gray is going to heighten the silver color. So that's another possibility for you, okay? So I hope that this was helpful, but I wanted to do this video mainly to show you what the white this year is. I'm really excited because it is my favorite white. I call it something different, but they're calling it Dove White for 2024. And I love it. I think it's a beautiful color. And it does, in and of itself, go with a lot, but not everything. So again, there's not a perfect white. And I think as quilters, you should always have a combination of whites in your stash. I would keep like 2 yards of a bright white, a kind of the dove white, and maybe a coffee white in your stash. That way you have something when you need it. But here's our next tip for you. How do you use white if you go into the stash and you find you don't have enough? Let's say you want to use the coffee white and you don't have enough of it. And it's no way to get out to a store, or maybe you don't live next to a store like I don't. I have to travel to get to a fabric store. So what do? You have other whites though. So here's my clue for you, or my tip for you. When you don't have all of the same color white, choose 2 that you have that are going to give you enough pieces to make your blocks and make your quilt. And then mix and match them. Obviously, they're not going to be the same color, but to the eye, they are going to look like that. What we think of as a mistake is intentional. And when your eye sees an intentional mistake, it looks correct. It looks beautiful together. So let's talk about, I don't have a piece here with 2 different whites in it. But, let's hold up this piece again. This piece, all of these whites in these different squares are the same because this fabric is all from the same collection. But let's say I was making blocks and I needed more of this white and I didn't have it. So what did we say? This coffee white, beautiful. This dove white, beautiful. So choose one of the other whites and then mix them and match them. So let's say up here, let's say we would do then our corners in the white that the pattern calls for that you want to use. But then we use the other white for our half square triangles. So we'd use the correct whites for all of our solid blocks. and we'd use the other white for all of our half square triangles. You're getting two whites, but for one, you're putting the same whites in the half square triangles, so those are going to match. And you're doing the same whites for your solid blocks, so those are going to match. So it's just going to look like intentionally you meant to have two colors, and it will give your block a slightly different look. It's going to be pretty. Your star is going to be a little more pronounced because your half square triangles are going to have a slightly different color on them. So that is my tip for when you don't have enough of one white or you just want to go scrappy. Now, if you're going completely and utterly scrappy, use all the different whites you want. Really mix it up. That will give it a completely scrappy look. If you want scrappy, let me grab our snowball piece here. Hang on. Oh, I'm falling off my chair. If you want to go scrappy, but you still want to have a completely coordinated background like I've done here with the dirty snowball quilt, then try to use all one white. How would I do this with two different whites? What I would do is I would try to do three corners of each snowball with one white and one corner with another white, so that when my four corners came together, these would look like a different color intentionally. So that's another way you can mix two whites. Do three corners. Do three corners over here in one white, and then do this fourth corner in another white, so that when you put your four blocks together, you get a different color block there in the center. You still have a white background all along the top and the sides, but in the middle, in these little squares that get formed, you have another completely different looking white color, and it would look lovely that way. And I do that a lot. Even though I keep a lot of the dove white in my stash, there are times when I do run out and I haven't been able to get to a store and buy another bolt or buy more of it. And so I just dig in and I start mixing and matching. Intentional mistakes. So they're not really mistakes. Intentional changes of color, when you do them that way, will always give you a beautiful look and something that to your eye will look correct. Okay. So, and you might have heard this also in reference to when you knit. Now, knit's a completely different fiber art, but when you knit, you're always told to buy all your yarn at once that are all the same dye lot so that you know the color is exactly the same. And that is super duper important. But let's say I was making this sweater and I had enough of this green to do my arms and my front and my back, but the ribbing for the neckline and the ribbing for my wrists and the ribbing for the bottom of this, I didn't have enough. If I chose the same color green, but from a different dye lot and used a different dye lot for these pieces, you would see a slight, very slight minute difference, but it would look intentional and it would look like it was planned to be that way. Alrighty. So that is my little primer on the color white and which is right. White comes in a lot of different varieties. There is no perfect white. It depends on the colors you're using in your quilt and what you like to see for sure. So I hope those tips were helpful for you on the color white. Now I want to talk about briefly why we're not seeing the layout for our quilt along, because I told you it would be coming this week because I actually put it off a week. I apologize from the bottom of my heart. You all know that I'm involved in a local musical, The Wizard of Oz. And all this past week, we have had shows. So Thursday, we had Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, we had rehearsals until like 10 at night. Thursday, we had two performances. Friday, two performances. Saturday, two performances. Today, Sunday, when you're watching this video, I'm at another performance. So it has been a super hectic, busy week for me. I've gotten very little sleep. I've had people pass out on me. I've had to do first aid for them. And I just didn't have literally the physical fortitude to get the layout stuff completed. So this is what the plan is, okay? For the quilt along, we will do the final layout the Sunday after Thanksgiving, because this coming week is Thanksgiving week here in the United States. It's on Thursday. That week is never a week that anybody gets anything done because you've got all that prep. And I want to get the new basic set out to you guys by Black Friday or Friday, the Friday after Thanksgiving, because we want to do a really big, great combo deal for you all. So that's what I'm really working on besides getting all the food prepped and everything else and getting the house cleaned up and all of that. But the Friday after Thanksgiving. So it's like the first Friday. Is it the first Friday in December, actually? Let me look at my calendar. Let's get us the right date. That is when we're going to do the layout. Let's see. So it's the 30th. That's 30th. So it is December 3rd. December 3rd will be the layout for the quilt along. Now, I know originally I said you had until the end of December to get your piece, your top done, to be in the drawing to get a free membership to one of the three free memberships to the National Quilt Museum. Don't worry about that. We're extending that timeline. You now have until January 31st. We're extending it out a whole extra month to give you plenty of time to have the quilt top done. You might be able to have your whole quilt done by then, but we wanted to give you that extra time. So the new layout date video is coming on December 3rd. The date to have the top finished to be in the drawing and post your photograph on either the on the Facebook page is January 31st. So let's talk about that for just a second. Facebook, our page is also So In Common. So once you get your top done, post it over there, your picture, so you can be in the drawing. We're giving away three memberships to the National Quilting Guild. And I'm going to tell you right now, we are going to have a giveaway for one basic set one. So build a block basic set one, which is your half square triangle, your quarter square triangle, and your square. There's going to be one giveaway for that. And there's going to be one giveaway for the brand new build a quilt basic set two. Okay. For those blocks, of which you don't know. You do know, if you've been watching the videos, that one of the new segment pieces in the new set is going to be the flying geese unit. Okay, but you don't know what the others are going to be yet. And that's still a surprise. It's coming. And I am excited to bring that to you because that will really help fill out the kinds of quilts and patterns that we're going to be doing and seeing in 2024. So there will be a special on these sets for the Thanksgiving weekend and in through for a little while, but it'll start on Thanksgiving weekend on the Friday. And we want you all to make sure and get them while they're at really great deals, because we're going to be using the sets a lot in 2024. We're not doing a technical free block of the month in 2024. We will have free projects like we always do, because it's important for us to get those out to everybody so that you can all be doing your quilts and stuff and giving the Build-A-Quilt system a try. But we're really going to be using the block one and the block two sets, okay? Alrighty, so that's what I wanted to share with you. So I am sorry that the layout did not come today. There was literally no way. I have one of those sleep deprivation headaches right here. And hopefully it will go away by Thanksgiving, because it's been a wild and crazy week, as they say. But we love having you all with us. Thank you to you all for tuning in. Welcome to all of our new subscribers. We're so thrilled to have you. And as we always say, please, if you haven't subscribed to So In Common, because we have a ton of videos. We have we're getting close to 500 videos that we've done now. I think we're like 480, 490, something like that. So we're getting really close to having 500 videos, you guys, out there to help you build your quilts with your embroidery machine. So just in case you're curious, that is one block from the Quilt Along, the Sawtooth Star. The Crossover Star is another block that's in this quilt. The Ohio Star is in this quilt, and the Inspired Star is in this quilt as well. So all of those made with your embroidery machine and a little bit of help from your sewing machine. Okay. All right. And so subscribe. Please like and share our videos. More and more of you are doing that, and I thank you so much. For one, that really helps me, and it also helps YouTube to make sure that others see these videos too, because you never know. You might have a friend who hasn't said anything to you, but they would really like to quilt, but they don't want to do it with a sewing machine only or by hand. They want to try it out doing a different technique. Piecing with your embroidery machine might be just the thing they're looking for. So thank you so much for your shares and your likes. I appreciate them no end. And I appreciate all of our subscribers. Every last one of you are dear to me. And I thank you for that. So please subscribe, like, and share. And until next time. Oh, if you still need to get any of the free blocks, because remember, everything for the Quilt Along is free. The instructions, the block sets, everything, then please go to our website, sewuncommon.com. They're still available, and they will be available through the end of the year. They'll be available in 2024 and still for free, but they're going to be wrapped up into, I'm going to put them all like in one package so that people don't have so many different things to look for. The reason we had to pick them this year was because these were all blocks of the month. So I'm going to just package everything up in 2024. Alrighty. Won't be the 1st of January. So just telling you now, won't be that, but I will be doing that so that they're all together at some point. Alrighty. Okay, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us today. Have a great rest of your Sunday, wherever you are in this big, fabulous, beautiful world of ours. And until next time, go make some beautiful quilts and sew life beautiful. Bye, everybody. And happy Thanksgiving if you're here in the United States. In fact, happy Thanksgiving wherever you are in the world. I'm thankful for all of you. Bye for now.